What's up, everybody? I'm Jonathan Sewell Sales at Mitchell Mazda on the Boulevard in Enterprise, Alabama, and we're here for another Mazda news update. And it seems like everything in the automobile world right now is talking about reduced production or lack of semiconductors or other things that kind of make you a little bit sad. But today's Mazda news update is a good one, because we're actually talking about a new vehicle line coming to America. That's right, a new vehicle line coming to America. And it's one that we're familiar with. It's the first electric crossover from Mazda, the MX-30. Yes, the MX-30 is coming to America. And yes, it will be fully electric. And yes, we will have a rotary powertrain, as we've been talking about. That's right, the rotary is coming back to America. So I'll have more details coming up on when to expect it, and also a little bit more of a dive into some of the powertrains that will be forthcoming down the line as this vehicle comes to America. So all that and more coming up on this Mazda News Update. Stay tuned. Yes, the MX-30 is coming to America, and as reported earlier in previous Mazda news updates, this spring, this vehicle, the fully electric MX-30 was supposed to debut or release in Japan. So that is the vehicle that we're going to see later this year in California. Yes, unfortunately, it is going to be released first in California this year, fall of 2021, and then working its way to other states and across the country in 2022. So I'm not for certain. I believe this will probably be a 22 model that debuts in the fall and then carries over into the spring for other states and other locations. However, it's big news for Mazda North America operations, as we've seen it and know about it in other places across the globe, but now it's finally coming to America. And yes, as we've seen previously, before that full electric came or was available in Japan, the MX-30 was available in a mild hybrid. And so we will be seeing some of those offers as well. But let's just start off the top here on the press release about that happened today, April 14th, on the MX-30 coming to America. This new electric powertrain will have an output of 144 horsepower and torque ratings of 200 pound-feet. So not too shabby for an electric vehicle. And this will fall right in line with the driving dynamics that us Mazda fans and Mazda passionate fans desire and love from Mazda vehicles. So it would have very similar driving dynamics that we're accustomed to. And of course, the unique but familiar styling of the MX-30, very similar to that CX-30 inside, similar size outside, but a unique look, which is what you want when you're talking about an electric vehicle. So it does have that futuristic twist, as you can see in some of these videos and pictures of this vehicle. And this new design, the MX-30 design, it's not really new, but new to this market, is what the president of Mazda North America is calling a human modern. So the human modern is that futuristic look, but very familiar with most of the same features that you would expect and love on your Mazda. So the speaking specifically about the powertrain, this is a E-Sky Active battery-powered, fully electrified model. Also, this will be coming, the 2022 will be offering a MX-30 plug-in hybrid with a rotary generator. So previously we were talking about a rotary range extender, and this will be a range extender. However, the rotary power, the rotary generator, will be directly fueling the battery or charging the battery, not powering the wheels or powering the driveline. So a little bit different than what we originally thought. We kind of thought that, hey, when the battery's depleted, the rotary range extender will kick in and power the vehicle. However, in fact, when the battery is depleted, it will still run with that extra power from the rotary generator. So it'll charge it back up. And that way, when you have the plug-in or the full EV, you will have the same driving experience, because the rotary generator is designed to perform in a quiet, as quietly as possible. So it will not have a different experience. You'll still enjoy the EV driving experience, which is a big twist compared to what other vehicles on the market are doing now. The biggest news for me is, you know, I love Mazda, Alabama, and Mazda Toyota Manufacturing in North Alabama will be making a new crossover, right? We've been talking about this, and there's still a question of if it will be the CX-5 size, the new larger platform size, or will it be between the current CX-5 and the CX-9, like a CX-7, you know, something along those lines. Last I heard, it will be that CX-7-ish size, and with these new powertrains that Mazda's bringing over for the MX-30, we will see a traditional hybrid powertrain for the American-made crossover. So I've heard that as well. Of course, being partnered there with Toyota, you knew some big things were happening as far as electrified vehicles. So we will be having an alternate powertrain coming out of the American-made crossover that is going to be sharing some components on that on this current MX-30 with that new platform. So that's good news, and that's awesome. So we'll be seeing that later on in 2022, I hope, right? There's still some questions on things going on. Each of these powertrains will be optimized for their specific platform. So the MX-30, the new larger platform. However, one thing we can count on for sure is that it will be a beautiful design, and the Mazda driving dynamics will be phenomenal, be the same across the line, although the powertrains will be specific. The rotary generator, of course, will mark the return of the rotary in America. However, it's going to be a unique powertrain because, as I mentioned already, it is charging that battery instead of actually powering the wheels. So this leads me to believe that we will not see a quote-unquote traditional rotary powertrain in the immediate future, like 2 or 3 years down the road. I don't expect to see that rotary engine or rotary powertrain solely that actually powers the driveline. So, unfortunately, we won't be seeing that, I don't think. I think we'll just be seeing it in this capacity of the generator aspect. Also, the MX-30, a little bit different than some of our other hybrids and electric vehicles across the industry, will be a front-wheel drive. So I'm sure that this is a couple of reasons. Number one, because they will just have the one electric motor up front. Most of your hybrids and or EVs would have two electric motors. So whether it's a weight issue or just how that powertrain works, they're going to be front-wheel drive. So if you have the fully electric or the plug-in hybrid with the rotary generator, I'm sure that that rotary generator is going to take up some space and add additional weight. So they will not have two motors for the front and the rear drive axle. So that's something that's going to be a little bit different than some others. But I think that the fuel economy, or in this case, the electric drive, will still be beneficial and still be just like driving a CX-30 or CX-5 now in front-wheel drive. When you're talking about electric vehicles, yes, they have batteries. So we've already talked about one way that they can be charged. Big news in this release is that you actually have, of course, the on-the-go charging that the rotary generator will offer. Also, I'm sure they will have some form of regenerative braking system, as most hybrids do. However, we know that you can, with a plug-in or an electric vehicle, you can plug it in to a level 2 charger, which is pretty universal, and charge it overnight or something along those lines. However, they will have a DC fast charging that in approximately 36 minutes, the battery will go from fully depleted to 80% charge in just 36 minutes. So that's fantastic because, again, Mazda vehicles are made to be driven, and even if they're electric, you can't drive them without power, without fuel, without that electric energy. So they want to make it as quick as possible for you to get back on the road and enjoying the drive. So they're partnering up with ChargePoint to help facilitate these things and make sure that you can keep that baby on the road as much as you desire. We've talked a little bit about the design philosophy. Of course, this will be a Kodo design philosophy or Kodo design concept vehicle. And all the while, they're evolving this. So this will, as I mentioned already, be a unique looking, more futuristic. However, it will kind of introduce the next lineup or the lineup of next generation vehicles inside and out. So there's a couple of new design elements. As I mentioned, the front of that vehicle is unique. Also, you have a floating center console. And with most hybrids and EVs, you will have a, in that floating center console, you'll have a couple of new items. First, an electronic shifting knob, so not more of a manual engage, but it will be almost like a joystick, which is fun, electronic shifter. And also, you will have a traditional Mazda commander control, and the trim, of course, as we've talked about before, will be a tribute to the 100-year-ago cork manufacturing that Mazda did, so it has some cork elements in there as some additional trim. And right behind the commander control or commander knob and the shift knob will be a new 7-inch touchscreen that will mostly handle the HVAC system. So your heating and cooling will be in a touch system. There's also going to be some other tactile buttons that will work with that system. So moving forward with technology and moving forward into this next generation of Kodo design elements. Now, some carryovers to that technology will be the connected services, the Mazda connected services. So much like CX-30, Mazda 3, CX-5, and CX-9 editions in 2021, the MX-30 will have connected services since we're here in America and already have that set up with other vehicles. So you can start, stop, lock, unlock the same features that you have now on some of those models. And I'm assuming that it'll be more like the CX-30 and Mazda 3. So you'll have some other benefits such as the tire pressure, fuel, things like that, that you may not have on the CX-5 and CX-9. So a lot of new technology as you would hope for and expect on an electric vehicle. You'll also have an added peace of mind by enhanced iActive safety features. That, of course, is a wide range of safety scenarios. And this design, of course, is designed to keep us safe, but also the high-strength body will help protect the space-saving battery. And so it kind of has all of the goods, a nice, strong body to help protect us and to protect the new technology. So in the event that there's any collisions or things like that, may happen, you will have that all that high voltage system and everything will be well protected as well. Mazda is offering a feature on MazdaUSA.com for you to stay up to date with the latest information of the MX-30. If you think that if you're in California and might get it in the end of the fall, or if you're waiting for more availability in 2022, you can go to MazdaUSA.com/vehicles. /electric/MX-30-electric-hybrid. So, or you could just go to MazdaUSA.com, right on the homepage there. It's today, live now, has a picture of those MX-30s. You can click that and go right to the option, the page to get notified with more information on this new electric vehicle. Now, the really big news about this is that it means that, yes, Mazda is going to bring the MX-30 to America, but that also setting the stage for more electrified vehicles. So we've already mentioned how it will be applied to a later series plug-in with the rotary generator and also be tailored for a traditional hybrid on the new platform, specifically the ones made here in America. So big things coming from Mazda, and I look forward to the first opportunity for me to put my hands on the MX-30. Might have to travel around to a couple of car shows or something like that in the near future, or the spring of next year. We'll have to wait and see. But yeah, I'm excited about it. The future is here. The future has made it to America, and you know, we're getting more green, which is always good, but also the same driving dynamics is really what Mazda's focused on, because they are always focused on their drivers. So if you have any questions or comments on the MX-30 or anything that we've discussed on this Mazda News Update, as always, drop them down below. I try to respond to every comment or question as best I can. Sometimes things get lost between some of the clutter there, and I can't find your questions, but you can always ask again. So I try to answer all those, and I appreciate you watching, and I really can't wait to see you in your own Mazda. So please send me any pictures or updates. You can text me or call me at 334-718-0504, and you can always email me. The email is listed in the description below, and more Mazda news to come. I'll see you on the next one.